It looks
what is
like,
she doing? Why does she do that?
It's like God just like painted each lovely leaf. Just so pretty.
Hey, welcome. My name is Art.
I'm Kendahl.
And we're here to talk about...
plants.
You betcha.
Of course. This week, we're going to talk about the color orange. The color orange in the plant world.
That's great.
It's amazing. And it's a really interesting color. The color in this situation, the fruit came first and then the color. Well, I'd say we love it, Art, but doing a little research this past week, I found that the most hated color actually is...
the most hated color.
Is orange. Isn't that crazy? We love orange. I love the bright, the amazingness of the landscape. The fall color, the amazing flowers. Sometimes some of the new growth, like an autumn ferns is orange, but it is not a favorite color of people. I mean, when people are polled in a survey, their favorite color, the number one favorite color is...
red.
Blue.
Okay.
Blue. And then if you break it down, men, it's green. For women, it's purple.
All right, what are we looking at here?
Is that fantastic?
This is made out of oranges.
Yeah. Is that amazing?
Where is that?
This is in France. They have a lemon festival there every year, and so they utilize all these different amazing citrus fruits. But the color, is that incredible? It makes me happy. It's just so beautiful. This is a movie, Jumanji. Have you seen this movie?
I have.
Okay.
I don't recall it. I remember it being really scary. I don't think this is suitable for children at all.
Uh-oh. Okay, but what's happening?
Terrifying.
Is a plant? Oh my god. This is terrifying.
Guy!
We'll pick a different one,
maybe. Yeah, see? Like, when.
That's scary.
It's a kid's movie and it's terrifying. Yeah, see, that never happens.
No.
Why does somebody imagine that plants would do that?
I don't know. That's horrifying because plants are so amazing. Can we share some awesome orange plants? Shall we?
Let's do it.
Oh, let's do some.
We got some plant pics.
All right. Ah, that's beautiful. That's really lovely. Looks like a...
that looks fall time.
It looks like a late summer fall display going on. Yeah. Ah, this is beautiful. That looks like a Christmas wreath.
Where did these photos come from?
That they've used... that actually was my photo.
Okay.
So this...
with French all over it.
Yeah, but... which makes sense as the orange
came from France. Is that like a little oven underneath the mailbox? Some gravel stuck in a little hole?
I can't figure it out. I'm not sure. Maybe you put the newspaper back in the day?
Yeah.
That's all I can figure.
You're taking a taxi, too.
It's very interesting. Okay. What do you think?
No, that's pretty weird.
I think I think this would be a beautiful landscape just without the tall.
Right.
You know? It's just chunking up that house. It's
not needed. Take them out.
Take them out. Move on. Ooh, that's very pretty.
What would you put there? Azalea could continue. You could have some more.
It'd be beautiful.
That azalea.
Because you feel claustrophobic walking into their doors. So there's something low and inviting to welcome you into their house. That's a very lovely landscape.
It is a lovely spot.
That's beautiful.
You'd hang out there.
Absolutely.
What's going on with the deer? Is that deer fence? And then there's like something...
It is. This was sent to us by a gentleman that we recently went to his property to do a film.
Okay, nice.
And he has a serious deer situation going on his property.
Okay.
But he's taking drastic measures for deer on his property, obviously. But
that's right outside our time-lapse studio.
It is, and it just makes me happy when I see it because a young gentleman on our farm built that out of old pallets. Isn't that fun, though?
It is.
He's turned like...
I thought that was really
cool.
He's
just turned this wall into a bench.
With just nothing more than a few pallets that he found.
Yeah, yeah. And he's made planter boxes, and I love it. So please send us your photos. We would love to see some awesome pics, or not so awesome pics. I'll be kind. I can assure you that. I'll be kind.
So I thought I would bring some orange junk food.
That nicely done.
I'm kidding.
Okay.
I can't stand these things.
Are you going
orange
to,
soda?
Are you going to drink an orange soda? Wow, I've never seen this before. This is, okay.
Not good.
Okay. Marigolds, orange marigolds, they're just happy. They bloom all summer long.
Yeah.
You can't beat a marigold. It's just a
And it's a plant. True orange.
It is. It's a very lovely plant. I love them so much. Once we get a freeze, they're going down. But what a great plant to say summertime.
Summertime, they love the heat.
They do. And
they don't like getting... They're not as fragile as a petunia, but they don't like a lot of water.
They can get very large where they're going to be hardy. Cold will keep them small here in our area, but here he goes. Oh, he looks great.
I kind of suspected it would be one of those bottom rooters.
Isn't it pretty, though?
But it is.
That's a nice fresh orange.
It's a lovely color. I mean, and it's just got more coming.
It does.
So it's a vigorous bloom.
How bright is that? Even on like cloudy days or, you know, in the evening or the morning. I mean, orange just pops in the landscape.
Hanging out together.
This is a Calincho, tropical plant. Again, this will not survive freezing temperatures, but man.
I love it.
It's just a blooming machine. Just blooms and blooms and blooms. These blooms last so long. Great. A lot of people will use these inside. A great plant. Wonderful plant. Loves art.
That is an annual.
Here it would be. Would not survive freezing temperatures.
So if you went down to Florida.
Oh, man. They'd be like edging and ground cover and beautiful. So this is one of ours.
Yeah.
Yep. This is the Canova. These are the orange shades of the Canova series.
I love them.
Man. I have them in my yard. Every cool color that comes out. But orange. Look at that. And it really, there are some lighter ones and darker ones. I mean, it really is a kind of a range of color in this variety. Cannas are amazing. So easy to grow. Just put them out there and say, see ya.
And you get a fairly long bloom time with the Canova series?
I deadhead mine at my house.
Okay.
Yeah.
So that extends the
It does.
Number
yeah.
of
and
blooms
it keeps
that
them neater, keeps them neat and tidy. But the Canova series is kind of cool because it doesn't get so large, so it isn't... He stays a little more compact, puts a lot of energy into blooming, so it's a great, great landscape perennial.
So June straight through into September?
Yeah. Oh, easily. Absolutely. You know, we were working on orange this week, and it just kind of jumped out. It's not orange.
It's not orange.
But,
you know, in the light, this newer growth, that does look orange.
It does. It's a beautiful variety. This has been out for several years.
It's not.
No. It's
like a bronze.
It's just a beautiful deciduous shrub, low and mounding, yellow flowers.
The coolest thing is this yellow
Isn't it sweet?
Margin.
Just a beautiful plant. Loves the hot sun.
Where else do you see that?
No, it's just stunning. Absolutely stunning in the landscape. Wonderful.
It's ridiculous.
Plant.
What is she doing? Why does she do that?
It's like God just like painted each lovely leaf. Just so pretty. Awesome, amazing plant. And it doesn't get big.
It's a miracle.
It's just a beautiful plant. Love the barberry. So you
have... Speaking of miracles. Oh. Is this awesome or what?
Really, really pretty. So this is the little... this is a series that we're growing, the Adobe Orange. This is part of the Sombrero
series. It's an Echinacea.
Echinacea. Coneflower.
Not a black-eyed Susan Rebecca...
No.
Line. You can get confused.
Yes. Nope. This is Echinacea. This series, the Sombreros, has been out for a few years now, but what a neat group because they don't get huge. It's a smaller, more compact.
Right.
And look at the flowers, and they just keep coming. Look at the buds down in here. That is amazing. It's like a blooming machine, this guy. And the finches love them. I don't know if you've noticed the yellow finches on the farm, but they love these seeds.
I love everything about it. I'm seeing pink fringing to the leaves, the petals, when they first are emerging. But then when you see the gradation of the orange to the yellow orange on these older,
it's like each one is a little in a different stage.
Elegant.
Isn't that fun? Yeah. It's a beautiful plant.
Classy, classy.
Loves the hot sun. I mean, as elegant as he looks, sit him out there in the hot sun. He goes, okay, I'll just keep blooming.
Right.
Yeah, great plant. And in the winter, it'll go down, but it'll kind of maintain a little bit of foliage at the base, but it's a great performing perennial in the landscape. Very, very, very tough, cold hardy plant. Not cold hardy. We grew this here at the farm.
This is an annual.
Correct. This is an annual. And he's, His little flowers were open. They're rather closing right now. But I kind of like the variegation, the little orange flowers against that variegated foliage. I think it's very bright.
Do we call it orange flower, not a red?
We call this orange. We call this tropical orange. Mm-hmm. This is one of the sun patients, so bring on the sun. Pretty cool.
Even with this yellow foliage.
Yes. Isn't that interesting? Yeah. You would think not. Being, you know, that lack of.
So if your landscaper's putting this in the full sun, don't worry.
Put it out there.
They know what they're doing.
Absolutely.
Or they're just lucky. Inside Voices, check this thing out.
Is that fun? No orange. No orange on this guy. But man, I couldn't resist this week, Art. Isn't he beautiful?
I can imagine this coming alive and.
Yes, like.
Roping my kids in.
He looks like he would, but he's actually rather gentle. Really easy to grow this from cuttings. Fast growing. It can grow about 3 feet long. They call it...
What are we calling it?
Several common names. A rickrack cactus, a zigzag cactus, or a fishbone cactus.
What's its real name?
The real name is Solanus sirius.
Solanus sirius.
Yes. So it's related to the night blooming sirius. But isn't he beautiful? Look at that.
Isn't it great? He's got some aerial roots coming out of it.
He does. It's just really neat. You can see where they had taken some cuttings off of this, or maybe it broke and there's some pieces growing. Seems to have a lot of vigor to it. I love it so much. This is so interesting. So it's based out of southern Mexico.
Okay.
Definitely won't take any kind of cold temperatures here. So, you know, it should come in the house when we start to get below 50 degrees. Put them back out next summer in the shade.
Where did you get it?
At a local garden center.
Were you surprised to see it?
Yeah, I was just really excited. I was like, oh.
Did you know the plant before you saw it?
I've seen them. I'd seen them online, but I hadn't seen one in person. So I was very excited to have one. So, okay.
What do we got? Rubber mulch?
Get
out of here.
This is rubber mulch. So some people...
For a playground.
Some people are all about it. Other people are like, oh no, that's not real mulch.
It has its use.
Mulch.
When I look at it with kids' playground, I understand. Yeah.
Perfect
for
a playground.
I've had kids.
Yes.
That have fallen out the slide. Yeah. And
The soft landing is nice.
They keep on trucking.
For plants, what do you think?
Heck no.
No. Yeah. I feel like it tried to get really popular there for a little while, and I think there's folks that are still trying to push the rubber mulch industry, but I'm not.
Mulch is not a permanent solution.
I'm not sold on it either. I'm just I'm in agreement. I'm in agreement with you. I just
All
wanted
right.
to.
So can you return this?
Let's find it.
Did you keep your receipt?
Let's find a neighborhood playground. Just go dump it.
Well, let's see if we love this one.
Okay.
It's a Hort film. It's a film we made.
I confess, I have seen this one before. This is a really good one.
I'm not a botanist and I'm not a horticulturist. I'm just like a plant person. You call me a plant person. There's plants everywhere. They're in your parking lot. They're not just in the forest. I like to think of spaces that are unconventional to harvest in.
Wow, what can you say? I think that's really cool that we get to find and tell stories about all these interesting people like this.
I want to go meet this person now, actually.
All right, so if you want to see the rest of the film, she's already seen it, but she'll probably watch it again. You can find them all on YouTube or at our website, plantpop.com. We make a new film every week about interesting people doing cool things with plants.
We do.
And you can join us here at the Plant Show.
Please do.
Send us your pics. We'll talk about them.
And we'll see you next time.
That's right.
All righty.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Keep it orange.